us names.
You dare call us names. You dare call us names. Under your parliamentary privilege, you are a public servant. You, sir, are a public servant. Remember that.
Please
run away about that. That's not my salary. You are a public servant.
We are the people who have worked this country. We have paid taxes. And you don't like that. You are the Jews.
In Marrickville, we have microphones available. Here you go.
Okay, thank you very much. Mr. Albanese, the question I've asked you is, what did you mean when you said the convoy with trucks and everything came from all over Australia? They came from Darwin, they came from Perth, and you called it a convoy of no con-
Consequence. Can you explain that, please?
Apologise first.
Thank you.
Well, apologise first.
Well, you either want to listen or you don't.
You don't want to listen. That's the problem, mate. You don't want to listen.
You're not listening to us. We don't want you.
When does Julia listen?
What I have said is that I support everyone's right to demonstrate their opinion. And you did it last week, and I support that.
No, you
and
didn't call us
today,
names.
And I support
you
that.
You called us
what
names.
What I don't support is the idea that some of the organisers associated with the rally said that the rally would lead to a double dissolution election and a new election. We have a democratic idea that you actually agree with people's right to have a say in our democracy,
we don't
then you're yelling
right.
me down, does
we
not do
where's
anything
our right?
for your case.
Well, where's your right? Right? Where's
and
our
if you
right?
want to, if you want to argue
where's
about
our
some
right?
of the criticisms that have been done,
where's
you,
our
have,
right?
you have a number of statements including some
right?
of the banners here today, Ditch Gillard,
where
with the Prime Minister
right?
drawn as a dog.
Question that has been set in by all of you members of COTA.
Loser!
Do you genuinely believe, sir, that your government has a mandate for this tax?
I have campaigned at each and every election since 1996 to take action on climate change. Ago, I organised a forum at Petersham Town Hall with myself and Greg Combay, the Climate Change Minister. And I can see he's very popular. With myself and Greg Combay, and there were more people there at that demonstration than are here today.
Your own mind whether he answered the question or not.
The next question I have for you, sir, is
concerning the actual effectiveness of this tax. So can you tell us how much cleaner the air will be after, say, 1 year of the tax?
I can tell you is that the tax is designed to reduce our carbon emissions by 5% by 2020. Which is the same target that Tony Abbott has. The same target as Tony Abbott has. The difference between us and the coalition is that we want to tax the big polluters and provide assistance to low and middle income earners. Tony Abbott will tax everyone and give assistance to the big polluters. That is the difference between the two proposals.
We have exactly the same target.
How much more money are you going to waste? Is that what you're saying, sir?
I'm saying that we have a target of reducing our emissions by 5% by 2020. I'm saying that just as the rest of the world is acting, we need to act. And when it comes to the issue of carbon pollution, I say that we need to listen to the scientists about the science. And in terms of the method of action, we need to listen to the economists about the way forward in terms of the most cheap and efficient way to reduce our emissions.
And all the economists tell us that it's a market-based solution that is the best way forward. You can't get anything right. We've actually got a scientist, an atmospheric engineer here today,
so you'll be hearing from him shortly. Now, the next question I've got for you, Mr. Albanese, is in respect of the actual pollution that's going to be reduced. Are you talking about CO2? Are you talking about particulate matter?
Bulldust.
Are you talking about soot, exhaust fumes? What is going to be reduced?
Bulldust.
I'm talking about our carbon emissions. We have a number of other proposals, including...
Okay, thank you very much. Now, are you aware? Two more questions. Fair enough. The next question concerns this issue of the actual CO2 in the atmosphere, which is produced by nature. Are you aware of what the percentage of CO2 is produced by nature?
I am certainly aware of CO2 being caused by nature. One of the things that the Parliament passed, indeed, last week was legislation about carbon farming. Carbon farming will be of great benefit to people in our agricultural communities, supported by you, but it is supported by the National Farmers Federation, and it is supported by mainstream organisations, just as last week, in terms of the demonstration, one of the things that I said in the Parliament last week was that the mainstream trucking organisations, the Australian Trucking Association, the Livestock Transporters Association, the Transport Workers Union, and other of the mainstream trucking organisations all did not endorse the rally last week. Indeed, I spoke to 600 delegates from the Transport Workers Union last Friday.
All right, well, I'll answer the question for him. Nature produces 97% of CO2 in the atmosphere. Now, that means that there is 3% remaining. That 3%, 1.2% of that is what is produced by man. So the final question is...
We want an election, we pay your wages!
How long will it take to achieve a 1.2% reduction in CO2?
Get up and stop!
We have here I know that you're not. But we're in a democracy. And what the first question, which is, what was I talking about the issue of no consequence? The issue is this, that 200 people demonstrating does not overturn a Democratic. Take a great deal of courage.
Get out of here!
For 150
people
to abuse one.
Get out of here!
To abuse one.
You're a loser.
But I do notice one of the signs out there.
Oh, you're a loser.
I do notice one of the signs
Another
out there
liar.
That I want to draw
liar.
The media's
liar.
Attention.
Liar.
Which
liar.
Is tolerance
liar.
Is
liar.
Out the most.
Liar! Liar!
I am firmly of the view, as the local representative here in the multicultural heartland of Australia, the inner west of Sydney, that tolerance is our strength. Tolerance is our strength. And you want to actually have that sort of sign, along with the sort of other signs that we see at this demo, my view is that there is nothing democratic about that, just as there is nothing democratic about the way that they've acted today. Thank you very much, Mr. Albanese. Can I ask? I've been asked by the local Chamber of Commerce to encourage people to have lunch and to contribute to our local economy here in Marrickville. Thanks for coming along.
Get out of our lives! Get out of our lives!
Get out of here!
We want an election! It's an incompetent government!
You can make your own mind up if you heard the truth here today. I have Sophie Mirabilla standing next to me. She's going to pass.
They're a bunch of people.
My friends, we are at a very sad time in Australia's history.
Yes.
Where many of us were angry at the bungled school halls, the pink bats in roofs, the NBN disaster. That anger is now being displaced with serious frustration and sadness. We had yesterday the latest disaster with the High Court, ruling illegal the government's Malaysian solution. And it made me think, it's not a cause for laughter, it's a cause for great sadness. Because this country deserves a government that governs in the national interest. A government that is not beholden to a few fringe dwellers on the extreme left in the Greens. A government that listens to mainstream Australia. That's what we need. We are facing difficult economic times ahead. We cannot afford this impotent, incompetent government any longer. The future of our country, this could be again the greatest country on earth. It does not have the government it deserves for the great people that reside in it. What I want you to do is never to be intimidated to exercise your democratic right to vote. Your democratic right to speak your opinion. Politicians are used to getting called names. I was called all sorts of things the other day in the Parliament when I was speaking about the Labor lies in not introducing a carbon tax a few days before the election. I'm not going to stop talking about Labor's lies because this country opposition that will hold this government account to account.
And we're behind you.
We had a counter rally of about 25 pro-carbon tax people here today, and that is their democratic right. But let no one belittle the voice and the numbers of people from one end of this country to the other who are fed up, who are frustrated. In fact, when you go around to pubs, when you speak to people in shopping centres, I find very few who are prepared to put up their hand to say they voted for the Labor Party. What people certainly don't want is the national government of this country to be beholden to a few individuals who do not want this country to be governed for the benefit of mainstream Australia. We need to be assertive, we need to stand up, and we need to appeal to those decent members in the Labor Party who know things are wrong. It only takes one person with courage in the Labor Party who knows that things stink now to cross the floor and bring early an election so that this country can have...
What I was saying is that all we need is one decent person in the Labor Party who knows that things are wrong to make a decision not just in the national interest, but in the interest of decent, hard-working Australians, the traditional support base of the Labor Party. Have the guts, have the courage. Please deliver us from this government. We cannot afford... We cannot afford two more years of this paralysed...
Look at this beautiful man! He's demonstrating. Look at this beautiful man!
Some of you have been ridiculed, and someone made a comment to me today that there are old people in the crowd, and guess what? I was told, oh, they're going to be dead soon anyway, so their opinion doesn't matter. I am disgusted and I am repulsed because democracy in this country should be available to all. It should not just be the get up and the trendy lefties. It is in every household, in every suburb, in every country town, the opinion of Australians matters. And what you have done, and I know what you will continue to do, is stand up for that right, the thing that makes Australia one of the best places on earth to live in. The people are not afraid to voice their opinion. Australians are fairly decent people. They're prepared to give a government a go, but enough is enough. This is the worst government in the whole, the worst national government in the history of our nation. Today, I'm Shadow Minister for Industry, amongst other things, and today we had the latest manufacturing statistics. There have been 26 months of contraction in manufacturing activity over the 44 months that this government has been in power, that the Labor Party has been in power. We see thousands of jobs disappear week by week, and that is not good enough. The government is sitting by, paralysed, unable to make basic decisions. We cannot afford it. You cannot afford it. Our children's future cannot afford it. Please maintain your right to a democratic say. Please do not ever, ever be intimidated. No matter how smarmy, no matter how sarcastic any member of parliament, no matter how exalted their position is, never be intimidated. Thank you.
Thank you, Sophie.